specifically, we're going to focus on releasing tension in our lower backs. I've noticed, at least for myself, I'm always sitting down at work, and when I come home, I'm sitting down again. Even after I work out, I'm just going to go ahead and say it again, I'm sitting down. So we need to loosen up those areas since they're very, very tight when we sit down. So let's go ahead and begin sitting down, ironically. So sitting nice and tall, legs crossed or extended. Find what works best for you. Take a deep inhale through your nostrils. And exhale out the mouth. Two more times, just like that. Just take notice of your breath. Is it long and steady? Is it going fast? Are you attempting to slow it down, to become present, to see what your body needs? And then just notice any areas in your body where you feel tightness, where you feel resistance. Just let it go with the exhales. Just taking your time to withdraw yourself from the outside world and check in with yourself. Those thoughts and brush them aside. And back to the sound of your breath. Few more breaths here. Straight. And let's go ahead and inhale the arms all the way up. And exhale, palms facing down, down, down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Slowing it down each time, connecting the breath with the movement. Two more. Here, allow the shoulders to relax, keep lengthening through the crown of your head, palms together, tuck in that belly button, engage your core. One more breath. Then we're going to slowly drop that left hand. Walk the left hand out. Keep the right arm up and over the head. So the bicep is by the ear, palm facing down. Press against that hand. Feel that nice long side stretch. So try to make sure that your right sit bone is on the ground as you press against that left hand. And then try to see if you can open up the chest towards the sky. So you're opening and you're leaning. And you're feeling and you're breathing. best for you. Hold for two more breaths. Inhale, come back to center, switch sides. Walk the right hand up, press against it once you find your edge. Keep that left bicep by the ear. Reaching up and over. Make sure that left sit bone stays on the ground. Gaze down, forward, or up. So eventually, I'm able to place my forearm on the ground, still pressing my hand and elbow into the ground to keep my left sit bone steady. So really, it just depends on how flexible you are. And to be honest, I haven't done this one in a while, so I'm definitely pushing past my comfort zone. But that's okay, that's what we're here to do. One more breath. Inhale, come back to center. Good. I'm gonna scoot a little forward here. Sun's in my face, that's okay. I can use some vitamin D. We're going to place your hands on the ground. We're going to go into a twist, so just be very gentle here. We're going to inhale the arms up, and then exhale, place the left hand behind you, acting as a second spine, so keep the hand close to your tailbone. And then we're going to place our right hand on our left knee. We're just going to inhale, lengthen, and just exhale, gently twist. No need to force anything, just being very gentle here, leading your heart towards the left side. Still leading with a proud heart. Our feet are flexed, toes pointing towards the body to keep the legs engaged. We're just gonna gaze forward for a moment. Focus on the lower back muscles. Send the breath to to that area. Allow the tightness to be released with each exhale. One more breath. And inhale, press back up to center. And then bring your legs up into a diamond shape. I'm going to go ahead and turn over this way again. Heels don't have to be close to the hips. You can keep them nice and far away. Make sure your ankles, make sure your hands are your ankles. Chest is lifted, and we're actively pressing our feet into one another to allow the knees to come closer to the ground, opening up the hips. So we're going to inhale, and then exhale. As you fold, let the elbows press the knees down closer to the ground. Lead with the heart. Again, to focus on your lower back area. So most of these poses are hip openers, and we'll focus on legs as well, but we also want to make that mind-body connection with our lower back. You can also release and walk the hands forward to really stretch out that lower back area. You can allow the back to round as your head falls and your chin tucks to the chest, continuously leaning forward, stretching the lower back. Just walk the hands back to center and extend the legs. Go ahead and widen the legs out like the letter B. Going as wide as your body allows. Keeping the feet flexed so the legs are engaged. And you should already immediately feel tightness in the inner thighs. Our hands at center, inhale, lengthen, and exhale, just gently walk the hands up, feeling the inner thighs become even tighter. Five more breaths, or you can walk the hands up a little more. See what that feels like. Hold for five more breaths. Done. Inhale, come back to center. Bring the legs together. And I'm going to turn over to the side. So we're just going to go into a twist once again. So let me just change. Switch legs. We're going to hug in the right knee close to the body. And then we're going to place the foot on the outside part of the left leg. Press onto that big toe to keep the foot planted. And then we're going to use our left hand to hold on to that right knee. Try and bring that knee to the center of your chest. Left foot is flexed. Inhaling, the right arm up, and exhaling, placing it behind us, second spine. Inhale once more, and exhale, use the left hand to pull and twist. So this time we may go a little deeper. If not, that's okay. Guiding our hearts towards the right side this time. Keep pressing on to the right hand. Keep the spine straight. Really good for your lower back. Just bringing some mobility into the space. We're going to do two more rounds. We're going to continuously stretch our lower back area, lengthening the spine. So let's go ahead and bend our knees. Keep the biceps by the ears. Engage your upper body. engage your arms and feel the spine lengthen. You can go ahead and alternate stretching the hamstrings now, bending one knee at a time, pedaling it out, or as I like to say, walking your dog. And then we're going to go ahead and enter our lunge. So we're going to inhale the left leg up and then bring it forward. Go ahead and drop your right knee. Glasses off. So we're going to come into a supported runner's lunge. So make sure your shoulder is on your knee. Your ankle is under or past the knee. Hands are on the ground. Hips are squared. Deep inhale. And exhale, send the hips forward. Gaze is straight down. Our breath is strong. If you wish to go deeper, take it easy, take it slow, no rushing. Hi, Marley. That's Marley. Okay, Marley, you need to sit down, please. Anyways, if you want to go deeper, go ahead and touch your toes, lift your knee off the ground. And that's pretty. Marley, get on the screen! Oh, Marley. Where were we? Here we are in our supported runner's lunge with the knee off the ground. If it's too much, drop that knee once again. That's okay. And send the hips front to back. Good. And then we're just going to go ahead and move into our upright lunge. So place one hand on your knee and then the next. Still focusing on our lower back areas. So we're going to inhale and exhale, send the hips forward. The reason for this lunge is to loosen up that muscle, the iliopsoas, which is attached to your lower back, wraps all the way around to the hip and down to the inner thigh. So make sure when you're in this pose, you're not collapsing over that knee. You want to keep your abs strong and engaged, chest lifted, shoulders roll back and away from the ears. And breathe. Last breath. Slowly roll your way back down, send the hips back, and bring that knee back to center to meet at tabletop. So I guess Marley's gonna be hanging out with us throughout the rest of this video, and that's okay. I hope that's right with you guys. I know she's cute, but let's stay focused. So go ahead and send your hips round and around, front to back, tuck and lift any movement here. how your body is feeling. We're halfway open. Halfway relaxed. And when you're ready, meet back in downward dog. Keep stretching the lower back area. And then walk your dog. Alternate bending one knee at a time. When you're ready, we're going to go ahead and do the other side. So right leg up. And bring it forward. Drop the left knee. Shimmy the foot forward if you need to. This time the right shoulder is being supported by the right knee. Our ankle stays under or past the knee. Hands on the ground. Gaze is down. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, hips forward. Five more breaths, or you can tuck the left toes, lift the knee off the ground, and hold for five more breaths. Keep sending the hips forward, keep your gaze down, feel the stretch, feel it open. When you're ready, go ahead and drop that knee. Send the hips back and throw. When you're ready, go ahead and place both hands on the right knee. Doing the same thing as we did on the other side. Taking a deep inhale, keep the core strong, chest lifted, shoulders roll back and away from the ears, and exhale, let the hips sink. Okay. Right now, Mikko. This is what happens when I leave the door open for the dogs to come out of it. That's okay. I could use the extra company. So focus on your lower back area. Imagine that piece of muscle like a rubber band. It's so tight. And for us to do this, we are stretching it out, loosening it up, excuse me. A few more breaths here. Last one. With control, slowly bring your hands down, send the hips back. Drive that leg back. Bringing your own kind of movement here. So notice how the body is feeling. If at any moment you need to take a break, go ahead and enter your child's pose. So your knees are wide apart, big toes together, the belly rests between the thighs, and the arms extend. Mm-hmm. you're ready, bring yourself back onto your tabletop. Knees under the hips, wrists under the shoulders. Tuck your toes, lift your knees off the ground, downward dog. Four, we're gonna go and lift the left leg up on an inhale. Exhale, place it forward, drop the right knee. And then as we send the hips forward on the exhale, we're gonna place our left hand on our left knee. Keep your right hand on the ground. We're gonna inhale. Exhale, press that left hand into the knee to come into a twist. Guide the heart towards the sky. Allow the Lord to fill it with love. Exhale, send the hips back, bring that leg back. Tuck the toes, lift the knees off the ground, downward dog. And then inhale the right leg, bring it forward, drop the knee. Left hand stays on the ground. As we send the hips forward, place your right hand on your knee. Take a deep inhale, exhale, twist. So just leaning forward as much as you can and twisting as much as your body allows. No pose will ever look alike. One day I'll be able to twist to the max, and then some days I just can't, and that's okay. We are not here to criticize our bodies. We're here to be humble, and be gentle, be kind to ourselves, to be patient with ourselves. And most importantly, we're here to love ourselves. So go ahead and find your breath. One more. And on your exhale, untwist, bring the hands on the ground, send the hips back, wiggle them side to side, do some cat-cow, do some circles, and let's go ahead and rest in child's pose. Big toes together, knees wide apart, arms forward, forehead on the ground, find your breath. Slowly rise and work your way onto your back. Keeping the knees bent, hands on the belly or on the ground. Allow your back to feel supported by the ground beneath you. Pausing, noticing. And then go ahead and windshield wipe the knees side to side. Being gentle, being mindful. Back to center. Place your left ankle on top of your right knee. Right leg up 90 degrees. Wrap your fingers around that right thigh. Take a deep inhale and exhale. Pull the legs into the chest. Let your left elbow press into the thigh or the knee. Allow the hip to open. Allow space to be created. switch sides. Right ankle on top of the left knee, left leg up 90 degrees. Interlace the fingers behind the left thigh. Feet flex, inhale. Exhale, pull the legs into the chest. Let the right elbow press into the thigh or the knee. One more breath. Pause for a moment. And then go ahead and bring the legs up 90 degrees. Kind of like you're sitting on a chair, but not really. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, drop your knees over to the left side. Make sure the hips are aligned with the knees. Place your left hand on top of your knees. And go ahead and extend that right arm to the right side, trying to bring that right shoulder blade as close to the ground as possible. Still twisting, still releasing tension, still letting go. Revive your body. eyes closed. And when you're ready, come to seated. Eyes remain closed, legs crossed or extended, spine is straight. Palms together, thumb to the heart. And we bow our heads to acknowledge ourselves, to honor ourselves and thank ourselves for this practice, for this life, for this day, for this time. We often find ourselves too preoccupied by what we have to do next, what hasn't been done, and so on and so forth, when we should really be focusing on the present moment. For this moment is so important. Every moment is important. So be mindful of your thoughts, be mindful of your movements, be mindful of yourself and the words that you speak. The light in me honors and acknowledges the light within you. Namaste.